Thank you, Mr. Chairman. At the outset, good morning to all of you, and I thank Dr. Anil Garg for inviting me for this very, very interesting session. I'm very privileged to be here. And the mix of fuel, mix of energy is a very, very challenging subject, especially a time when India is also part of the Paris Accord. If you look at the global demand as well as the mix of energy, it depends on several factors. Historically, if you see that, one is population explosion, urbanization, steady economic growth. What are the types of fuel available is quantity, technology, and in the recent times, two factors have taken a very important seat. One is the climate change, and other is sustainability. So these are some of the key factors which will really decide the future energy mix. 2030 is a benchmark time. If you look at historically, from 1850 to 1900, then population rose from 1 to 2.5 billion, and today it is about 7.5 billion globally. As far as urbanization is concerned, in 1800, only 10% people lived in urban areas, and today, almost 54% people live in urban areas, and the prediction that by 2030, about 65% people move to urban areas. That will really increase the requirement of energy. In the last 50 years, if you take global average, we are having a GDP growth of about 4%. The fuel mix in the past have been between 1850 to 1900 was ruled by biofuel. This is basically the firewood and coal. 1900 to 1950, it was coal, biofuel, and emergence of oil and gas. 1950 to 2000, it was coal, gas, and then emergence of nuclear in 1960, solar and wind in 1980. Now, technology plays a very, very important part. Winds have been blowing from the time Earth was made and human civilization has been, but wind power came as late as 1980. Same thing about nuclear, it also came quite late. Solar energy, sun has been shining since time immemorial, but solar energy actually came as late as 1980. For the benefit of students, probably you may not know, many of you may not know, that up to early 19th century, that today the petrol is the most precious product, petroleum product. It was actually a waste product. The most important petroleum product was kerosene, which was used for lighting, till the technology brought in internal combustion engine, and only then the word petrol became so important. The importance of gas also was came in almost 10, 15 years. 40 years back when I joined oil industry, the gas discovery used to be like a morning. In my second well, which I was looking after, we had a very big gas discovery. And when I came with a great happiness that we have discovered so much of hydrocarbon, so much of gas. So my boss was very unhappy, kya Srivastava, क्या गैस डिस्कवर किया, ऑयल डिस्कवर करने से कोई बात होती, बट देन दैट गैस हैज बिकमिंग सो इम्पॉर्टेंट टुडे. सिमिलरली द टेक्नोलॉजी ऑल्सो हैज प्लेड ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. इफ यू लुक एट जस्ट लास्ट 10 ईयर्स, यूएसए वॉज नेट गैस इम्पोर्टर, नेट ऑयल इम्पोर्टर, एंड द टेक्नोलॉजी हैज रियली रिवर्स्ड यूएसए in the net gas exporter, and today USA produces more crude oil than the Saudi Arabia. In fact, it is exporting crude oil even to India. We have been talking of renewables, including hydro power and biofuels, etc. With so much of discussions we are having almost in every conference. But if you take the real contribution today of this renewables, hydropower, biofuels, etc., it just works out to be only 5% in the entire energy basket. The new dimension which has come up, which I mentioned, that climate change and environmental impact, sustainability. So these are going to play a very, very important role as far as energy mix is there in the coming years. As far as any country is concerned, the energy mix will depend on the production, distribution, consumption, and availability of energy. As far as India is concerned, there are two of the four pillars of energy, future energy, are one is efficiency and sustainability are related to the climate change. In fact, all the European countries are today are set to increase their renewables by 20% by 2040. There could be five disruptive trends which will impact the energy transition and future energy mix, both globally as well as in India. Firstly, the advanced mobility, the continued rise of electrical vehicles, emergence of autonomous vehicles, and development in transport sector. Most of you know almost 45% of the petroleum products are used in transportation. So that's a very, very important sector. Electrification and renewables, electric needs to rise and grow at the rate of 2% per year till 2050. And 80% demand will come from China, India, Africa. Out of that, 60% will be in the buildings, 25% by the energy, by the industries, and 10% from the transport. The third factor is the energy efficiency improvement and carbon capture. In fact, carbon has been always, in every conference, everywhere, is branded as the villain. But actually, carbon is not a villain. It is the way we use. There's a good carbon, like trees. There's a neutral carbon, which is coal. And the bad carbon, which is the emission. So it is for us to use the technology, convert all the bad carbon into good carbon. So third factor is energy efficiency and improvement of carbon capture. Carbon capture definitely to reduce the emissions. Then the advanced fuel and materials which are coming, advanced biofuels from non-food-based biomass and sustainable material. This was not done earlier, firstly because oil and gas was abundantly available at very cheap rate. And second is the technological advancement in converting this non-food-based biomass into energy. And lastly, which is India, is digitalization, which oil and gas industry, it is in early stages of adopting these technologies. But if you imagine, today the number of mobile phones which we have in the country, and every mobile phone needs energy. So these are, as of India is concerned, there is a little impact of digitalization, but as we move with the time, this will have more and more impact. Now there could be three possible scenarios for future energy mix in the above five trends, both in India as well as globally. Scenario one could be a clean energy revolution, transition to clean energy in acceleration to meet the goal needed for climate change and universal access. Second scenario could be road to efficiency, energy growth driven by efficiency measures and towards sustainable sources. And thirdly, continued momentum, that is a business as usual. Now if we take all these factors, these five disruptive trends and three different scenarios, in 2017, India's energy mix was, out of total 897 million ton oil equivalent, coal was 45%, oil was 25%, natural gas was 5 to 6%, biofuels 22%, nuclear, hydropower and other renewables 1% each. So if we take 2030 scenario, in the business as usual situation, the energy requirement will be of the order of 1775 million ton equivalent, out of which coal will still go up by 5%, coal 50%. Oil will remain 23%. Natural gas 7%, biofuel 11%, nuclear 3%, hydropower 1% and other renewables 1%. If you think of clean energy revolution where we climate change and sustainability takes a very, very important seat, the requirement of the energy will be 1,274 million ton oil equivalent. Coal will go down to 28% from current level of 45%. Oil will remain at 22%. Natural gas will definitely go up from 7% to 22%. Biofuel will again also go up to 12%, nuclear 3%, and renewables will grow 15%. Chairman mentioned a very, very important gas source, which is gas hydrate. In fact, 15 years back, nobody would have imagined that the kind of technological progress which has happened in the shale gas, shale oil in USA. But today, because of shale gas and shale oil which has been discovered, which is being produced because of a good technology, so we do not know. As on today, the way we understand the technology, which are used in the energy sector, tomorrow we may have, in fact, if we take the gas hydrate reserves in India, mapped reserves, that should be able to sail India for next 50 to 100 years, natural gas requirement. But today is the technology is not there. Japan, in a small way, they have tested a production, done a production testing. So is Korea, South Korea. But in India, we are yet to conduct production testing. Maybe tomorrow, if we find a technology of converting this huge gas hydrate reserves to use of the mankind, tomorrow probably this whole scenario may change drastically. Thank you very much.